There are many Taoist practices and countless ways of self-cultivation. We separate two: the Waiguan, the external practice, which is, for example, incense burning, reading sutras, health practice like Daoyin Gong Fu and so on, painting talisman and Taoist ceremonies. And the second is Neiguan, internal practice, meditation, sleeping meditation, tuna, the breathing techniques, and everything which is internal and without movements. Many Taoists create their own way of cultivating Tao to fit their needs and transform their weaknesses into its strengths. They practice, for example, martial arts, not to use it as a self-defense, but more or less to cultivate their character.
We一般就是用三个方法修炼，这个方法是叫一静、一动、一念。 就是一静什么意思？一静是安静，就是练安静的，就是功法。打坐、站桩。一动什么意思？一动是动作，我们是练刀音、气功。 拳法，这个都是算一个动作。 然后一念什么意思？我是修道的时候，肯定是要。 念经术，就是天天念经，是对自己的修行，也是一个很大的帮助。 我们一般就是练这个站桩功，就是在很安静的地方，在。 庙里或者在山里，在一个很自然的地方，就是站桩。站桩是一个很重要的基本功。我们一般练拳练的少，练基本功练的多。这个站桩功法是很简单，其实没那么复杂，但是练的时间长，就是自己的劲气越来越大。然后站桩就是很简单，我们就把这个一般就是练这个。 混元桩，就是把胳膊抬起来，就是胳膊肘、手和剑是一个线，就是圆圆的，就是我们抱一个很大的气球嘛，然后含胸八杯，头顶，就是石头也往上顶，就这么站，可以闭眼睛，也可以开眼睛，就是稍微。 小一点开，一定要放松，身体要放松，呼吸也要呼呼吸吸的，安静的，就是越深越好，越安静越好。然后这个后背这个命门也要放松，往下坐。有一个说法就是，就是我的思想就是往下坐，就是似坐非坐。 就是思想往下坐，但是不是真的坐的。然后这个膝盖也不能超过这个脚尖，这样就很放松，可以这么站，可以站40分钟、1个小时，或者2个小时也可以这么站。这样就是一个很好的练功方法。如果你一个人在家里练。 也可以练这个站桩功，如果你跟很多人一起练也可以，最好是找一个很安静的地方，没有别人，就是打扰你了。 就是你练的时间就是越长越好。如果刚开始练，肯定是练2分钟，就是胳膊特别酸特别累。如果有这个感觉，就是很对的。如果你每天加1分钟，就是好的。过1个月，你自己算一下，可以站多久。然后你站的时候，肯定是4项，就是来回调，这个4项要安静下来，就是我们4项就放在呼吸这个方法，这个练功方法也叫缩心圆，就是把那个后子缩在心里面，就是把10项放在4项越来越少，然后把这个后子缩在心里面。然后呼吸很安静，就是身体放松，最重要的要放松。然后一般我们练大坐时间长，身体有可能是比较软。我们还有一个功法叫就是功力，练功力很重要，是我们就是用这个初级组是。以前就是用一个方法，就是叫魔性石。这个魔性石什么意思？我们就是拿一个石头，练石头的时候，我们就是慢慢的可以魔性。魔性什么意思？就是把自己的性格磨圆，就是可能是以前就是有烦恼啊，有冲动啊，有比较容易生气啊，或者什么的。这个性格会有变一个很安静的，一个很柔的一个性格，一个人就是变成一个好一点的修行人。
Patriarch Chu Chuji practiced the stone every day.He carried a big stone up the mountain, and when he was on the top, he would throw it down. And with every throw, the stone became rounder and rounder.
This is 魔性石。魔性石，我们就是练石头，就是有用动作或者把它抬起来上山，就是。跟初祖是一样，就是把石头抬到山上去，然后把它扔下去。这个石头扔下去之后，每一次就是会变圆一点。这个练时间长，就是身体会有非常有劲儿，因为你天天拉这个石头，天天抬山去，会有也是一个很大的帮助，就是。你大坐多了，这个身体会有非常软，但是你必须有一个就是阴阳合一嘛，你大坐是阴，你练功力是阳，这个是很重要的事。
In Wudang, many Taoists practice Tai Chi Chuan, which was created here, and is not only health practice or self-defense, but also moving meditation and communication with the universe.The five animal Qigong is based on the play of the five animals created by Hua Tuo, an ancient physicist and doctor. Each animal is related to one of the five elements, which are water and tortoise, wood dragon, fire crane, earth tiger, and metal snake. The practice balances the five elements within the body.And it helps to preserve health and longevity. Another martial art which practices the five elements is Xing Yi Quan.
Yang Kuishan, a student of the famous Wudang master Li Jinglin, was also a student of the Badi master Li Shuwen and the Xing Yi master Sun Lutang.
This is how Xing Yi was introduced into Wudang Mountains.Ba Gua Zhang is the martial art based on the 8 trigrams of the I Ching, the Book of Changes, Dong Hai Chuan, the founder of Baguazhang, stayed in Wudangshan and learned the circle walking meditation of the Taoist monks. And also he learned the techniques of the twisting hands, Zhuan Shou. Based on these two, he created Baguazhang. One of the weapons used in Baguazhang is Ziwuyue, the deer horn knives. Dong Hai Chuan was also a master of this weapon. Wudang masters are famous for their sword skills. There's a saying which is, in the north we admire the stick of the Shaolin, and in the south we honor the sword of the Wudang. The practitioner uses his sword more like a painter his brush, light and feeling like water. There are several boxing styles and weapons practiced in the Wudang Mountains. Every school, lineage or master have their own styles passing down from generation to generation. If one uses internal strength, we can use the basic technique Peng to ward off any attack. The roots of a practitioner should be deep as the one of a big tree, and he should be heavy like a mountain, unable to be pushed away. Dao Yin exercises are like Taoist yoga. Dao Yin means stretching and leading of the internal energy Qi. Unrelated to the age of the practitioner, everybody who practices this on regular basis is getting a healthy and flexible body. Erzhi Kung, the two finger skills, is a good example for the control of the breathing and the internal qi. Here the practitioner demonstrates the two finger skills where he lifts his whole body weight only with two fingers of each hand. This is only possible because he is in full control of his breathing and internal qi.
一般我们练功也有很多就比较奇怪的一些练功方法。我现在就差不多十几年就练这个二德功。二德功是什么呀？二德功可以点穴，也可以治病，就是推拿，就是可以用气，就是治病，就是按那个穴位什么之类的。练功的时候或者就是修炼的时候，我们就是练自己的心嘛。
Another Taoist practice is Bigu. The translation of Bigu is without grains. The meaning is that the Taoist practitioner is fasting and doesn't eat grains. Sometimes the practitioner don't eat any food or drink water for more than 2 or 3 weeks, sometimes even more than 100 days. But there are also practitioners who totally misunderstand the practice of Bigu. Many practice and they get sick because they do not practice the internal practice to prepare themselves for the Bigu period. It's also important to practice Bigu in a secluded mountains, because high in the mountains, the environment has a high ionic level, which is good for the practice of Bigu. If one wants to cultivate the Dao, one must cultivate the own character first. Xiang Xu Xin, Xian Xu Xin, which means you want to cultivate the way, you first have to cultivate your own heart. The meaning behind the saying is, if you can't cultivate your own heart and calm your character, you won't be able to reach a high level of enlightenment, or even cultivate the Tao at all. It is important to accept your own destiny and find your own Tao.